You're a nerd. But after that conversation, I knew we would be friends for a long, long time. But I didn't know that you would be locked in as my best friend till the end. The crazy thing is that we would just continue to have these great conversations that ended up teaching me so much about you. I learned that you have been through so many hurdles already in life, but you never let it stop you. You will always be the most happy person I've ever seen. Even if it was gloomy outside and we had so much work piled up, you would still be smiling, dancing, or singing with that beautiful voice, no matter what you've been through that day. Do you remember when I used to always ask you, why are you always so happy? That was the censored version. And I would ask with this confused look on my face. Because I knew you had been through so much pain and frustration through life that any person would have plenty of excuses to be mean and have that rough interior that I normally have. But you're always smiling and always the nicest person in the room. From that point, I knew that you had a good heart. And I could go on and on about what I've learned in the long conversations that we had at the library, at UAB's dining hall, even though they tore the building down and built another one. Some restaurants eating ice cream. And just to give you a preview of some of the conversations we would have, one of the conversations I would always ask her, like one of the things I asked her was like, what's your favorite food when we were trying to get to know each other? And she would say ice cream. And I was like, that is not a food. But anyway, we just clicked. We shared so much information with each other, which we both agreed we've never done before. Those first conversations gave me the signs that you were a great person. When we started to hang out away from working, and then I realized that you, when you were talking about yourself, that you completely undersold yourself big time in those conversations. Hanging out with you proved to me that you were everything I learned and more. You just have this great positive energy that radiates from you. That energy helps me get through my tough times. And you've gotten me through my toughest times in life. You always challenged me to be a better person. You have always been my biggest cheerleader. I can honestly say that you brought out the best in me. That conversation was just a preview of getting to know, those conversations were just a preview of getting to know the most beautiful person I've ever met. You have a beauty that is truly inside and out. Since those conversations 8 years ago, you have always been on my mind. We have been inseparable ever since, and I still do not want to go another day without you by my side. I know that we have this, something that is real. So Kiara, I bow to you today that I will always have your back. I will always be there through sickness and health, and you get sick a lot. I promise to protect you and always communicate my thoughts to you, and I promise to always listen to you when you need to talk, when you're frustrated or rambling about what happened in your day. I promise I'll always strive to generate my strong passion for you into that same positive energy you always gave me till the end. I love you, Kiki.
Amen.
Oh.
Now we're going to see what the legal vows, which to me, that was just as legal coming from the heart. You can't get more legal than that. Especially before God and those who are born, they're going to keep it again.
Amen.
For the state of Alabama. Carol, take this way. I'm going to ask you a question. And you reply with that one. Carol, we have this man to be your husband, to live together in the covenant of marriage. Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Maurice, will you help this woman to be your wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as we both shall live?
I will.
Now we're going to do the ring exchange. We're asking God to bless these rings. These rings are a sign of the vows which this woman and this man bound themselves to through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. You want the bride for this? On the ring finger. Won't you repeat after me? I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol.
As a symbol.
Of my love.
Of my love.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I shall have.
And all that I shall have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And with all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Now that Maurice and Kiara have given themselves to each other by solemn vows. And I love the first one. With the joining of hands and giving and receiving of rings, I do now pronounce them as husband and wife. Every head bowed. Eternal God, creator and preserver of all life, the author of salvation and giver of all grace, look with favor upon the world you have made and for which your Son gave his life, and especially upon this man and this woman whom you have made one flesh in holy matrimony. Give them the wisdom and devotion. Grant that their wills may be so knit together and their spirits so knit together that they grow in love and peace with you and one another all the days of their lives. Give them grace to recognize and acknowledge their faults and to seek each other's forgiveness and yours. Make their lives together a sign of unity. Make their love a sign to this simple and broken world that unity may overcome estrangement, forgiveness may overcome guilt, and joy may conquer despair. Bestow on them the heritage of children and the grace to bring them up to know you and to love you and to serve you. Now in the sight of Jesus Christ, our Lord, and these wonderful blessed people and family and friends, I do pronounce and present you before God and the state of Alabama and all the other states, the continents and their countries and everywhere else. I present you as Mr. and Mrs. Maurice Harley. Yes. You may kiss your bride.
They look so beautiful up there.
Okay, I know you can. Oh, damn.
They did good. They did it.
Yes, they did. I'm so proud of them.
Okay, we got a big round. Yes, we do. Hey, Teresa, how you doing, girl?
Yeah.
Okay, y'all, let me end this live stream. Bye-bye.